हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द न्यू लेक्चर सेशन। माई सेल्फ शंकु घोष, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट डॉक्टर सुधीर चंद्र शू डिग्री इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अंडर द जे आई एस ग्रुप। टूडे विल डिस्कस अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज कॉल्ड हाइब्रिड व्हीकल। दिस इज टेकन फ्रॉम द मॉडल नंबर 1 व्हिच इज नेम ऑफ ट्रेंड्स इन ऑटोमोटिव power plant. This topic is basically taken from the subject of modern vehicle technology, and the subject code is AUE 704B, and this is the 7th semester automobile engineering students subject, and it is an elective subject, so student can easily choose. So before starting the class, now let's look the objective of this class. Student can understand easily, find out what to define easily, easy to define height, to easy to define the hybrid vehicle. Number two, they can classify the various kinds of hybrid vehicle. Next, they can understand that what are the component uses for to manufacture a hybrid vehicle. Next, they can easily understand the benefits and the what are the benefits and what are the limitation about this hybrid vehicle and vehicle, and the outcomes that the student can easily understand the difference between hybrid vehicle and the electric vehicle through their classification and component they have, those are using, and student easily understand about the various student can easily define the hybrid vehicle and can easily understand about its history. So student, let's start the hybrid vehicle. Hybrid vehicle definition: a hybrid car is any car that uses both electricity and the fuel injection in order to run, that is called hybrid car. So hybrid car basically defined as a vehicle, hybrid vehicle is defined as a vehicle which is used both electricity and fuel injection system that is called hybrid vehicle. So as you can see in this picture, there are three types of vehicle picture shown. First one is conventional. In case of conventional car, this is a fuel tank. From fuel tank to connected with the engine, and engine power is produced and then is transmitted to the, and through the transmission it will provide to the, and the power is provided to the moving. So in this way the vehicle is moved. So this is the conventional way to move a vehicle, to drive a vehicle. And in case of battery electric, there is a battery pack which gives the power to the motor or the generator, and motor and generator, this is the production powerhouse which is produce the power to the transmission system, and then transmission, the help of transmission, the wheel translate will start to move. So in this way this battery electric will be moved. So in the and in case of hybrid electric vehicle, hybrid electric is a combination of both conventional vehicle and the battery electric vehicle. Here you can easily see in hybrid vehicle there is a fuel tank, engine, and then it goes to the power to the transmission. Another side is a battery, and then it goes to the motor or generator, and then it goes to the transmission. So basically transmission is connected power from the both side, One is the conventional way, another is the battery electric way. And so that is why this vehicle is known as the hybrid vehicle. In history, in 1889, William H. Patton, a patent and application for a gasoline electric hybrid rail car, which is propulsion system, and for a similar hybrid boat propulsion system. So, in year of 1889, William H. Patton, patent and application for the gasoline electric hybrid rail car propulsion system. The next year, that is in the sorry, next later in the year of 1900, Ferdinand Porsche, who was employed at the Lonard coach factory, and he developed a mixed, which is a four-wheel drive series hybrid car, mixed four-wheel drive series hybrid car version of the system Lonard Porsche, which is approaches in the 1900 Paris World War. Next, in the year of 1901, George Fisher sold the hybrid buses to the England. In year of 1902, Knight Naftal produced a racing hybrid. In year of 1905, Henry Piper introduced a hybrid vehicle with an electric motor or generator, batteries, and a small gasoline engine. And in the year of 1931, Eric Gachin invented and drove from the Attenborough to Berlin a 0.5 or half horsepower electric car, which is containing features later incorporated into the hybrid cars. Now coming to the working principle of this hybrid car. The hybrid car utilizes power from both electric and fuel. Fuel means it uses maybe gasoline, maybe diesel or hydrogen. So both the electricity and the fuel is used to reduce the emission while improving the fuel while improving the fuel efficiency at the same time. On the electric side, the car is powered by energy. The car is powered by energy, which is stored in lithium ion battery. Power is stored in the lithium ion battery and sent to the electric motor or generator. And this motor power the wheel and also generate electricity when braking through the regenerative braking. So, from the point of view of the electric side, so first the car is powered. First of all, the car is powered from the powers which is powered by energy which is stored in the lithium ion battery, and then the power is sent to the electric motor or generator, and this motor, after getting the power, is also provided to the fuel and also generate electricity when the braking through regenerative braking system. And the hybrid car do burn fuel but use small engine with emitting low emission. So hybrid car burn the fuel but use small engine that emits the low emission. The engines are used either to generate the engines are used either to generate power for the battery or work in conjunction with the electric motor to provide the drive, or work in conjunction with the electronic motor to provide the drive. Now, after knowing the working principle, now coming to the classification. Basically, the hybrid vehicle is divided into two ways. One is the type of powertrain, and number is the type of the degree of hybridization. Number of powertrain in the types of powertrain. According to the types of powertrain, hybrid vehicle is classified into three ways. One is series hybrid, number two is parallel hybrid, and number three is series and parallel hybrid. And according to the type of degree of hybridization, hybrid vehicle is divided into two ways. One is mild hybrid and another is full hybrid. So student, let's start with this series hybrid. The traction power which is delivered by the electric motor, while the internal combustion engine, via a generator, and produces the electric power and produces to electric power to drive the electric motor to drive the electric motor. So the traction power is delivered by the electric motor while the internal combustion engine via generator will produce electric power to drive the electric motor. So as you can see in this picture, this is the engine, the internal combustion engine, this is the generator, this is inverter, battery, motor, and this is the fuel. So first of all, power is transferred from engine to generator, and then generator to inverter. And the another way, in the electric side, the power is collected. Power is passes from battery to inverter, then inverter to the motor. So in the inverter, both the power is collected from the electric side and from the conventional side. So then it marched and to passes through the motor, and then the motor. So then the motor is passed. So as you can see in this picture, so here the excess power, the traction power. So as I told here, the traction power which is delivered by the electric motor, while internal combustion engine via a generator produces electricity power. Via a generator produces electric power to drive the electric motor, and the excess power which is stored into our battery pack, the IC engine is decoupled from the driven wheel and can operate mostly in the maximum efficiency region The major shortcoming of the series hybrid drive chain configuration are the high power installed in such component and the request of a generator. In fact, the energy from the IC engine is converted twice before to drive the fuel. And thus the system is more expensive than the parallel. So this is the series hybrid system. This is parallel hybrid. In case of parallel hybrid, there is direct mechanical connection between the hybrid power unit and the wheel. There is a direct mechanical connection in between the in between the hybrid power and unit hybrid power unit and the grid. In addition, this layout has an electric traction motor. That drives the wheel and can improve a share of braking energy. In order to change the battery for the regenerative braking system or help the engine during the accelerated condition. In fact, the IC engine and the electric motor are both the coupled by these mechanical devices. There can be a torque coupled with a single shaft for two shaft configuration, single shaft or two shaft configuration. A speed coupling with the planetary gear unit and a march of both the previous coupling. So student, you can see in the picture, this is the picture of the parallel hybrid vehicle, where this is the internal combustion engine, this is the transmission section. So the power is produced in the engine and it passes to the transmission, and then transmission to this mechanical linkage it passes to the vehicle. So this is a one way. Another way is from the electric side, from the point of view of the electrical side, that is from battery to inverter, the power is passes through one battery to the inverter, then inverter to the motor, and then motor to the vehicle via these mechanical linkage. So this is the one way, and another way is this is the another way. So both the case mechanical linkage is get the power and then it drive the wheel. So that is why both the power is coming simultaneous on the passes through this mechanical linkage to the vehicle to move the vehicle. That's why it is called the parallel hybrid. Now coming to the next, that is the series parallel hybrid. The series layout and the parallel layout are merged together. The series layout and the parallel layout are merged together in order to have both the advantages. In particular, the ICE is able to supply the electrical motor or charge the battery pack thanks to the generator. So in this way, both are connected, series and parallel, both are connected. As we can know that for the series parallel system, the power passes from engine to the generator, then generator to inverter, and on the electric side the battery to the inverter, and then in the inverter they are collected from the both side, the conventional power and the electric power, and then it passes to the motor, and then the motor provides this power through the linkage, through the mechanical linkage to the wheel to move the vehicle. So this is the series way which we can already learn, and the series section and the parallel section, engine to the directly link mechanical, this linkage to the wheel, and the another side is battery, inverter, motor, and then mechanical linkage to the wheel, and in this way the vehicle is trying to move in both the case here, and this is the parallel section. In this case they are both occurring simultaneously. One is series section and the parallel section, and both are divided with the help of this planetary gear, and this planetary gear is used the main purpose. The first one is the planetary gear is divided into two way to which is power which is when it collect the power from the IC engine and it divided into two way. One is one portion is passing through the generator and another is passing through the mechanical linkage. So in this way this system is occurred. So this is called as the series parallel hybrid vehicle. Now coming to the mild hybrid, the electric motor which is generator between the engine and the transmission. The electric motor generator is placed. Electric motor generator basically is placed in between the engine and the transmission. When the armature or rotor of the motor, armature of the motor actually replaces the engine flywheel in the many design. So then the IC engine and the electric motor share the same shaft, and after that the IC engine and the electric motor share a same shaft, and it cannot turn without the other. So one cannot turn without the other. So this means that a mild hybrid cannot have the electric launch feature. Cannot have the electric launch feature on the full purpose of full hybrid. The electric motor cannot turn the wheel independent. It can include all the other features. The electric motor cannot run the wheel independent of the engine. It can include all of the other features of fully hybrid generative braking, ideal stop, and a downsized engine. The General Motor Corporation's GMC Sierra pickup and the Honda Civic and Honda Accord are the mild hybrid, which is designed according to the mild hybridization. And in that case, the basic difference of the mild hybrid and the full hybrid, that they are the power section. In case of mild hybrid, the IC engine and the electric motor, both of them sharing a single shaft. So for power is produced, so that is the way one cannot run without the others. Now coming next, that is a full hybrid. A full hybrid is a vehicle that can run only a combustion engine on an electric motor or a combination of both. So in case of fully hybrid vehicle, where the vehicle is run only on the combustion engine or only on the electrical motor or the combination of the both. So a full hybrid will feature engine stop. The full hybrid will feature the engine stop or ideal stop feature. A full hybrid will feature a downsized IC engine. A full hybrid will also feature regenerative braking. And a full also features the regenerative braking. The Toyota Prius, Toyota Camry Hybrid, Ford Escape Hybrid are the full hybrid vehicle. Now coming to the parts of the hybrid vehicle, the main components of the hybrid vehicles are prime mover, electric motor with a DC to DC converter or DC to AC inverter on the controller. Now next is energy storage system, and then transmission system. प्राइम मूवर, द प्राइम मूवर ऑफ ए हाइब्रिड व्हीकल, द प्राइम मूवर ऑफ ए हाइब्रिड व्हीकल इज इट्स द मेन एनर्जी सोर्स, द मेन एनर्जी सोर्स विच जनरली इज वन ऑफ द गैसोलीन, डीजल और द फ्यूल सेल. The selection of the prime mover, the selection of a prime mover is mainly based on the requirement of the drive ability, fuel economy and the emission also. So first, to make a hybrid vehicle, so student, to make a hybrid vehicle, first of all we need to select a prime mover that may be gasoline, that may be diesel, that may be fuel cell or any other. So and this selection is basically based on, the fuel economy, emission and the drive ability. So after that we'll go for the next component. So this prime mover is the main component for the hybrid vehicle. This electric motor with DC to DC converter, DC to AC inverter and the controller. The electric motor is one of the most important in hybrid vehicle. An electric motor is one of the most important component in a hybrid vehicle. The brushless DC motor and the AC induction motors are widely used. A brushless DC motor and a AC induction motor are widely used for this application due to higher efficiency, lower cost, less maintenance and a longer lifetime. The mechanical brush or the commutator system is replaced by a motionless electronic controller. DC voltage vary with battery. An operating condition in hybrid electric vehicle, either LDC motor or the AC induction motor, has to work with a DC to DC converter or DC to AC inverter, or to convert the DC voltage to the required operating voltage level of the electric motor. Next is energy storage system. The energy storage system, one of the most important subsystem in a hybrid electric vehicle, which consist of an energy storage pack, a voltage, current and temperature measurement module a cell balancing circuit and a cooling system. So the energy storage system is one of the most important system for the hybrid electric vehicle. And it consists of an energy storage pack, voltage, current and temperature measurement module. First one is energy storage packs, second one is voltage, current and temperature measurement module, a cell balancing circuit and a cooling system. So there are basically for this energy storage system, basically we use the lead acid battery, nickel cadmium battery, nickel metal hydride battery, lithium ion battery and lithium iron phosphate battery. So these are five types of battery we are basically used for the energy storage system. Now coming to the transmission system. The transmission is another important subsystem of the drive chain and perform the following function. Number one is achieves the transition from a stationary to a mobile state. Number two, converts torque and rotational speed from the mover to meet the vehicle's momentary traction requirement. Number three, provide for forward and reverse motion. Provide for forward and the reverse motion. Number four, it has the best fuel economy and the minimum emission while meeting the drivability which is a requirement. Now coming to the difference between the hybrid vehicle and the electric vehicle. According to the definition, electric vehicle also referred to as an electric drive vehicle. The electric vehicle is also referred to as an electric drive vehicle, which is a vehicle. This is a vehicle uses one or more electric power, which is a vehicle which uses one or more electric motor for the propulsion. Now next is the hybrid vehicle. A hybrid vehicle is a vehicle which is using two different form of power, such as an electric motor and IC engine, or an electric motor with the battery and the fuel cell for energy storage. Source of propulsion. The electric car gets all of its power from the electrical sources and thereby is a completely non-polluting zero emission vehicle or ZEV. In case of hybrid vehicle, a hybrid car drives some of its power from a conventional gasoline engine. According to the charging time, in case of hybrid vehicle, it has very long charging time, and in case of electric vehicle, it has very long charging time. And in case of hybrid vehicle, the plug-in charging is not required. According to the range, in case of electric vehicle, maximum 600 miles. So according to the range, the electric vehicle, the maximum 600 miles. Tesla Roadster, 600 miles is the range for the electric vehicle. 600 miles means 965 kilometers. And in case of the hybrid vehicle, the maximum range is 40 km in the Toyota Prius Prime, where the 40 km means 24 or near to 25 miles, 24.8 or near to 25 miles. And according to the torque, in case of electric vehicle, electric cars are renowned for their instant torque, and in the hybrid vehicle, not generally present in the gasoline. Now coming to the advantages, it is a fuel efficiency increase. It increases the fuel efficiency savings, low emissions, reduce the noise pollution, low maintenance costs, so safe to drive. So these are the advantages of the hybrid vehicle. And the disadvantage, this is a more expensive, limited battery life, expensive battery pack during the replacement part cannot be very parts can be very expensive to repair, and which is slower than the petrol power car. So these are the disadvantages of this hybrid. So students, here in this section we discuss the hybrid vehicle, and after the completion of the class, we can understand about the hybrid vehicle, its history, its working principle, its working nature, its components, its classification according to the power. Differences in between the hybrid vehicle and the electric vehicle, and then we'll go for the study. So Then and after that we will study. We cover the advantage and disadvantages of this hybrid vehicle. So that is for the hybrid vehicle. From the next class, we will discuss another topic. So till then, stay at home and stay safe. Thank you. Thank you so much, students.